Welcome to our channel Raptor Fishing Tackle. Today we're going to talk about the blood knot, which is basically this kind of a knot. As you can see, this is a very strong knot and it is used to connect the main line to the shock leader, or you can use it to connect a braid line to a monofilament when you are backing up a braid line spool with a monofilament line. Normally I would use a barrel swivel. I am more comfortable with a barrel swivel. A blood knot is used when you are joining up two lines together. So I'm going to show you how to do it. First thing is first, I'm going to use two different ropes. I have used a rope so that it is easy for you all to see, and with two different colors. So first thing you need to do is overlap these two lines. First I'll show you. You have to overlap these two lines just like this. Take ample of line on both the sides because you have to twist it and squeeze it in. So take ample of line in both sides. Then what you need to do is hold a line with two of your fingers over here. Hold a line just like that and twist it on this side 3 to 4 times. I am doing this 4 times because this is a thick line, but if you're using a 0.40 or 0.30, 5-6 times would be fine. After you have looped it 3 to 4 times around the red wire, you have to pass it on through this hole which is there over here and pull it out. Then the second thing you need to remember is that hold these two lines again and twist this red colored rope onto the other side, not the same side, the other side of the line 4 times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Once you have done that, remember to pass the line through the socket which is over here, meaning this line should be here and this line should pass and reach the other side of the line. So the blood knot should be somewhat like this, so that there is one line passing, the white line passing through this side and the red line to the other side. Then slowly pull it out. For a braid line, you need to wet it a little bit. You need to apply spit, or you can add water to it so that it is a bit moist and then it can pull very easily. But for a monofilament, you can directly push it out. So as long as you push the line slowly, it creates a blood knot. This is how you connect any line, your main line, to your shock leader. This is the easiest way and it is the cheapest way to connect two lines. And this is pretty strong, as you know that blood knots have their reputation of their own. They are used by most of the anglers and they keep the knot very thin. So the advantage of the knot is over here is that they keep it very thin, so it can pass through your guides very easily. And on top of that, passing through your guides is a different case. It has no abrasion. It won't get stuck in your guides, neither you will be able to feel it in your reel. That is how good the blood knot is. So this will help you a lot in adding or joining two lines and keeping it stronger than ever. To demonstrate you all how exactly it fits on the main line, I am gonna cut off the setup which I have with the barrel swivel and put an Invisi line over here. The barrel swivel from my main line, this was an Invisi line. I'm gonna keep it aside. I'm gonna take a new invisible line. I usually take a meter long is very comfortable for me. And the Invisi line, the fluorocarbon which I'm using, is from Suffix. This is Suffix Invisi line. It is 0.47 mm, which is pretty thin, and it has a 15.7 kg breaking strength, so which is pretty nice. These Invisi lines are a bit expensive. For 20 meters these are a bit expensive, but if you don't want anything expensive, then you can always try the Suffix shock leader, which is a mono line. This is a fluorocarbon. You can always use a mono line if you want to. That is a cheaper way, but these are practically invisible in water. So that is how good these lines are. So this is my main line. I am not aware that if you are able to see properly, but this is my main line and this is my leader. So now I'm gonna hold a line with two of my fingers over here and twist this main line over the shock leader. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times is actually more than enough. Then you pass it through the front hole which is there over here. Once you have done that, leave this section of the line and hold the other part. Once you have holding the other part, you have to twist it in the other direction which is then not the same direction you have done before, but the other direction. Pi times 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once you have done that, pass it through this side of the line, which is there. And the equation should be such that one line is on this side and the other on the other side. So that is the same equation also here itself. Once you have done that, once you have one line on this side and one line on that side, pull the main endings which is there over here and just twist it inside so that it can create a knot, which is doing. So it is a beautiful knot that has been created. So this is the blood knot. Once you have pulled it very tightly, cut off the edges which are there from here as well as here, trim it out in a decent manner. As you can see, this blood knot is pretty thin and you won't even feel it. That is the best thing about the blood knot. Once I have joined both my shock leader as well as my main line with a blood knot, I would put a Dyna snap at the end of the line. These Dyna snaps are from VMC, and VMC makes one of the best Dyna snaps. I love them because the size 2 number itself can hold 13 kg. So my whole setup, I have kept it in the range of 13 kg. This is the main line, is a advanced line which holds advanced 0.30 line, which holds 13 kg of weight. The shock leader is there, which is 0.50, which holds around 15 kg of weight, and the barrel swivel of that holds around 13 kg. 13 kg load, then I can definitely take it. So 13 kg was a number that I selected, and I started taking all the accessories which I need. If there is something less than that, then there is a chance that if there is a load or a pressure while catching a fish, it might break. So 13 kg was my target. I never went down. 13 kg was my main concern, and I kept my border at 13 kg, and I took everything above that. And this is now I have connected the Dyna snap with a fisherman's knot. I love fisherman's knot because it is very easy to do so. And once I have done that, I would stick my plier inside the Dyna snap and then pull it out so that it is pretty tight, because once I cut it, it won't be able to take as much strength as I need. So I'm gonna make sure that it is perfectly tight and then cut off the extra material. You can always go on the blood knot, or you can put a barrel, your choice, but blood knots are very easy and cost efficient, so I would definitely go for a blood knot. Thank you so much for watching our channel. Please like, share, subscribe, and do comment.